September 13th is the 18-year anniversary for when Tupac was killed. What do you remember from Tupac, and what does that mean that night? I mean, Floyd's fighting Maidana, obviously.
Tupac, very inspirational to me. One of my favorite artists, if not my favorite artist, you know. That's one artist that really motivated me to even do music and actually making me believe that I was him. So, you know, not many artists can do that. You know, Tupac is one of them. And, you know, it means a lot to me. I'm a big fan of his music, of his movies, and he was just a great person. So this is going to be a monumental night. You know, I didn't even know September 13th, so yeah, that's put me on to some history. But I know, I believe, I think John Singleton is doing a film on Tupac, so you know, that should be a great film. You know, they were scouting some locations out in Vegas. I can't wait to see that movie when it's done. And you know, that's what it is. Tupac is a hip-hop legend, you know, might be top one. You know, it's controversial between him and Biggie, but you know, both of them was up on the list. But you know, my vote, you know, Tupac get my vote.
You being from Harlem, being from New York, was it easy to be a Tupac fan? Because I know the whole thing was real hard. Even me, I wasn't as fond of Biggie at first, because I'm from LA, but you get over it. How was it for you around that time? Were you guys still accepting him?
Well, you gotta accept greatness, you know, just like with Floyd. You know, even if you don't like him, you have to accept the greatness. So he was a great artist, and he was just a motivational person. So, you know, he was more outspoken than Biggie. Biggie was more laid back. So that's why I think he got more recognition, you know, than Biggie. You know, the music kind of matched, you know, talent-wise, but Tupac put out more music. He worked a little more. He's actually kind of from like the Bronx, Harlem type area originally. So, you know, I got to, you know, experience Tupac a little more than Biggie, and he was out a little more before, a few years before. So, you know, I would have to lean more towards Tupac. You know, you said you was from the West Coast. It didn't really filter down to y'all to after, you know, especially with the beef going on with the East and West Coast beef. So, but, you know, at the end of the day, I think everybody around the world appreciates Biggie and Tupac.
And you know, Floyd, you know, his days as a fighter are coming shorter and shorter. He has a few fights left. You've been there for many years seeing him. I asked the other TMT guys this. Are you trying to, like, relish in it and enjoy these moments? Because they're not going to last for too much longer, everybody in the gym having this kind of environment in there.
Yeah, well, you know, it's been a long ride. You know, the ride almost over, but it just opened the door for new things, you know. So I'm not looking at it like, you know, we are going to miss these moments, but, you know, we're going to get into more things like films and producing the music a little more, and just different things, you know. There's a long life after boxing, so we look forward to that too.
Your prediction for the 13th, September 13th, Mayweather Maidana 2?
You already know.
Okay, my last question. There's a lot of talk. Even yesterday, I was at a big event in LA, and everybody said Mayweather Pacquiao, May of next year. Some people even told me a two-fight deal, ESPN people.
Well, I don't know, you know. I just know about the fight that's coming up right now, you know. I find out when y'all find out, and I'm in the inside. So, you know, when Floyd announces it, that's when I find out. So, we just wait and see. You know, we got the September 13th fight on Maidana. You know, it's going to be a tough fight. You know, the guy really has his confidence. He really feels that he gave Floyd a good run last fight. I don't think so, personally. I'm not being biased because Floyd is my friend and my family, but it is what it is. I'm just calling a spade, you know. Floyd is much more faster, much more talented, much more intelligent. So we're just going to see September 13th, but I believe Floyd is going to fight a different fight. You know, not going to square up so much and go toe-to-toe. You know, Floyd is the best boxer in the world, so, you know, if he fights on the outside, it's going to be a domination, you know what I'm saying? And he's going to have a whole fight in his hand. So, you know, we all know Floyd might mix it up, you know, a few rounds inside, a few rounds outside, you know, but we all know we're going to come to the victory.
And have people watching, if they want to follow you, what's the Twitter, the Instagram, the website?
Everything, the Harlem Hot Boy, the Gmail, the IG, the YouTube, the Twitter, everything, the Harlem Hot Boy, you know. So that's my handles for everything, you know. Might want to holler, you know. I'm suitability right now, and that's what it is, you know. September 13th, Mayweather versus Maidana. It's boy P. Rilla, TMT, Mayweather Promotions, Filthy Rich Records.
Thank you so much.
In the ring, P, you got in the ring?
There you have it. FaceofTheGoin.com and Melissa Pack reporting.
A business guy, you know. I'm a envelope pusher, you know. Some guys more hands-on with the boxing, and you know, you got the equipment managers and you got the trainers and stuff. I'm more on the business side of it. So during those times, I'm situating people, making sure they got to see. You know, Floyd has a huge family and a lot of friends. So, you know, those whole times I'm getting everybody situated with a seat and stuff. You know, nobody ever could meet me at one place and just me. So I'm running around and I always get to the fight kind of when Floyd's fighting. So this year though, you know, it's gonna be a lot different. I'm gonna be in the ring. Have my credential pass. So I never have a credential pass. You know, I'm gonna have my TMT, my money team sweatsuit, Mayweather promotion sweatsuit, and you know, I'm coming full force. You know, and then after that, you know, we got an after party. So
that'll be the first time you're actually in the ring during the fight.
Yeah, yeah. I might hold the belt up or something like that. And you know, I guess my warm up, you know, would be Jay Leon fight.
Walk him out.
So I'm gonna get to the fight a little early so I can prep myself for those things.
Appreciate the interview.
Thanks so much.
Thank you. All right, baby. Thank you.